Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is video number 12 in our RubyGem NerdDice series. And in this video, we're going to tweak our config based on some of the conversation we had last time about random number generation. And then we're going to apply that config to our existing total dice method. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to modify the readme sum to clarify the randomization techniques and the new random interval options in our config. So the first thing I'm going to do is go into my terminal. I'm going to check out a new branch. Make sure we are up to date with Origin Master. We are. And now we're going to got a new branch now. We can start our development. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to take our readme and we're going to throw it into the GitHub markdown editor. A random item. Well, we'll probably knock this one out pretty soon as well, but right now I'm just going to paste into the write a comment here and preview. So this is giving us what we need. I'm going to go in and I'm going to make my modifications to the config documentation, and I'll pause while I do that. So I've made my changes. We look here. I'm going to reduce the number of options here. So we're going to have secure random, which uses secure random, random rand, which uses the class method rand on the object with the shared seed object there. Random object, which allows you to have a separate random object with its own seed, and then randomize, which will kind of shuffle between the other three options. And then I changed one of the options to the name of the option I changed to refresh seed interval, and I made the default nil instead of 50. So this will refresh the seed interval on both the random rand and the random object at that interval. So, but I don't think it needs to be set by default, so I'm changing the default on that. So we'll get our item back into the readme. Save it. Sure that only the diff we want is in this, which is good. We will so we've got a commit now, and we have some out of date code that we need to add here. So we're going to go to back to our comment here and cancel it if we can. So we just got rid of the text, and now the option to comment is gone there. So go back to our code, and we've changed our options in our array, and we have changed the name of one of our items here in config. So we need to go to our configuration spec. There is now we'll make the this is our default. So we're going to change the default. Going to let you set one different. And we're going to change the name of this attribute. You to reset, refresh seed interval. And then I'm going to refactor. So you can see here we've got config equals describe class dot new. We've got a lot of that here. So we're going to add a before item here where we do picked config. Get rid of this from all of our specs. All right, so we've got no method errors. Some failures, so we'll go and set our items here to help them pass. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to change our options here. Options there. And then our attribute accessor, we need to change that name actually, we want the default to be nil, we can just get rid of setting that instance variable. So we're down to one failure. Has a randomization technique of random new once. Configuration, set that. So we're back to passing with our full suite. RuboCop is happy. Get diff. Refactoring. So I've got that working. Now we want to be able to use this config when we roll the dice. So we already have our nerd dice total dice item here, but we're using just the system rand dot number of sides here. So I'm going to add a private method here. Pause and think for a moment while I think of a good method name for this. So I'm going to call this method execute die roll. Number of sides. For right now, we'll just make it use the same thing that we've had before we modify it. So number of sides to remain here. So this should still pass. But it is not. Getting name error. So let's see. Nope, still not. It's a private method, I bet. So let's make that protected and see if that. Still not letting us work there. I'm going to pause for a second and figure it out. So problem here is that I'm making this an instance method, which will not work. I can go back to private here, but it just needs to be self dot. And now we're back to passing. And RuboCop is noting here that we should do a class self here block instead. So we'll do that here for both the both of these methods. So I want to get rid of the self dot in both of these. See if that still works. It does. And RuboCop's happy. But this really hasn't gotten us any more interesting in terms of what we're doing. It's just moving this down a little bit. So now we need to add a get number generator. So we're doing is here is we're gonna get the generator from configuration. In most cases, you're going to just use your configuration and you're going to return a specific item here. So by default, this will be nil, and now we've got the option. And then we'll go case statement. I don't like the name option. We're going to keep using generator as our option. Rename that using generator. And then in our configuration options here, we have a few options that we can provide. Same so we've got this now so here. We can just use the when then item to keep these. More succinct. And then when randomized is going to be the tricky one. Let's see if we're passing with things as they are now. Still working. Part of the reason why it's still working is that we have an unused variable here. So let's make that our next item. Still passing. Now we need to handle this randomized situation here. So we're going to have a going to use this. Random. Going to call this method itself. Recursively. So that seems to be working, but right now we're only using our default configuration for this, and RoboCop is upset. Many lines. So let ourselves be auto-corrected here. So we've got cyclomatic complexity and method length, which we can probably live with. And we could get now we've just got the cyclomatic complexity issue. And I think that we're just going to So we'll get back to that later. We're just gonna now temporarily we're going to add a put statement here. See what we've got. So, and we're doing it a lot of times. We might want to do this in the console here. All right, so we've got an error. Okay, so we're getting uninitialized constant, secure random. Let me see. I want to return the top level random and the top level secure random when I do this. Getting issues with uninitialized constant. So I believe the reason why I'm not recognizing secure random here is we can get rid of these double colons here, is that secure random as a library is not required by default. So going to use it, we need to make use of it. We need to require it in the project. So in this case, you can see in all three cases, it came up with something different. Those are three 25-sided dice. Oops. We want six 25 here. So that is working as intended. We're getting combination of random, secure random, and the like. So that is giving us what we expect here. And then if we want to change it. It's random every time. Secure random. So this is working the way we want it to, but how do we test that this is happening? So we've got all these items for total dice, and we want to make sure that these work for all of the different configurations that we've got when we run our test suite. So you're going to create here a shared examples folder, and we're going to call this code from our different configurations. So here we're going to have a new folder. Copy this. Copying this here, and then in our shared example version of this, we're going to call this shared examples the And then going back to our main method here, we're going to say we're going to have some context blocks here. Start there. Let's see if that works. Nope, that is not. It's failing on the require here. So that worked, but you can see that it's using random, which we don't want. So that is working as intended. It appears to be, so we should be able to do that with the rest of our contexts. Now we're running this . You can see our number of examples have increased. So that is we're going to reduce this in the shared example down a bit, at least. Temporarily, so that I can make sure that it's calling all the shared examples as I want. So I'm going to temporarily make this change. Scrolling up. with secure random technique, and it's using randomized. So we need to fix this. Gonna go back here. We're going to do that. Put this in a before block. See if that fixes things. This is all random with the random object. This is all the random class. This is all the secure random class. So that's giving us what we want. We can now take out the put string method here, and we can go back to our larger sample size. Although I will I'm going to actually make this something that we make configurable. T- tone it down a bit to 200. So that it, because it's being called so many times by so many different items here. Still working. Now we want to get the puts method out of our item here. And there we go. So that is giving us what we want there. We'll see how RuboCop likes us. Okay. So five of our offenses are auto-correctable. Okay, so we'll correct those. We've got cyclomatic complexity. Private method here. Us where we want, and then RuboCop is now happy, so we will call this a win. We'll in our next video implement the ability to reset the seed, but let's squash our commits and push this out to the remote. So right now, three commits ahead of master, so we'll rebase against master. Reword, fix up. I'll pause and write the final commit message. So we've got our commit message here. Sign our commit.
Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.